Heineken Green Synergy starts now.
I am DJ 47. My birthday, 4th of July.
Okay, hi world. I'm DJ Naz and I love music.
Hi Jamaica, this is DJ Jerry, one of your contestants.
DJ Banka representing Mocha, which part I come from.
Okay, I'm Donald from Mandeville representing
Green Synergy.
Richard Inarity, DJ Inarity.
Heineken.
Green Synergy.
Green Synergy.
Hey, what's up, people? It's your girl Tammy Chin, and of course, you're watching Swaggerific TV. It's Heineken Green Synergy 2010. Now, last week's episode was very exciting because our DJs got the chance to meet our third resident judge, Grandmaster Flash, the turntable legend. Take them to school, let me tell you, and I'm talking about chalkboard and all these things because he was teaching them the art of DJing.
You gotta be able to count, head count in your head. You gotta be able to keep a clock in your head. So if you wanna do embellishments in between the beat, you can go here.
Of course, we also had a challenge and one of our DJs got eliminated. So our Heineken DJ six pack is now down to 5.
Hello, I'm David. It's right now. It's a hard road to travel and a mighty long way to go. Right now, you come like say, I'm not lying to you. I'm so nervous, but I'm still confident. I'm not shake. I actually vibrate like my phone.
But yeah, nobody not call you.
No. I mean like vibrating like the phone. Yeah. Big up blush anyway there.
Yeah,
anyway there blush. Big up yourself.
Big up all of them. Kumbad, all of them. Eminence, all of them. Yeah, watch it, everybody.
Everybody were out tight. Dig up on yourself. Not done.
Danite.
Competition is stiff, but the race is for the swift. But who can endure it? No, the race is not for the swift. No, I swear you guys ain't hearing clear what I'm saying. The race ain't for the swift. S-W-I-F-T. No. No, that's swift. But who can endure it? I swear that guy has something in here. Channel it.
We're at Heineken Green Synergy's home away from home. I'm talking about the Fiction Lounge. And earlier, our DJs got the chance to meet with some of Jamaica's finest. We're talking about people like DJ Delano from Renaissance. We're talking about the Turntable Twins, Alaric and Boyd, Richie D. Listen now, one bag of people. Let's go inside and see what's going, yeah? Come on. Dwayne. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, madam.
When did you know you wanted to do this?
Alright, people, right now we're interviewing, Narrative interviewing me. I don't know what's going on. We're gonna see what's going on here, so yeah. Well, you know.
Yeah, man.
So,
what's it?
My mommy said, from the first day that she home.
You're DJing, not singing.
Oh!
This is not any of those other shows.
No, you're up, no. This is weird, dog.
Well, I tried watching, you know, and improvise and it shows. So, but I'm not going to tell you a lie, I'm not really 100% funny.
Yeah. Yo, you are the reason why I use the turntables too, yeah.
Yeah.
I used to go to high school and I listen to the mega mix them and everything. Yeah. So, yo, yeah.
That's what we do now.
That's what we do. But for most of us, we never really had teachers, okay, we had to do our own
things. Nobody taught me. We all of us, I think, pretty much learn by osmosis. Yeah. We see things, pick up things, and you go home. And like I said to you all yesterday, practice. But for all of you, try to, you see that basic thing? Clean transition and tight mixing and beats locking up. Try to get that done. That's the basis and the essence of DJing.
Problem is, what is happening now is that other people, the world is watching us too, you know. Right? So whatever them see happening, them feel that's how
that it's okay. So yeah, that's exactly the right thing that's going on. How do I get?
And that's why I say, who teaching the young DJs? Right. If the young DJs doing this and making all kind of noise.
Young DJs are learning from young DJs. Exactly.
Yeah, but the older DJs, some of them not teaching
it
anything.
You
know, say,
right, but no, like I just said a while ago.
Yeah, but
not somebody's going to school. You just
sometimes you have to go and pick up. Pick up
and just pick up the good habits from where you can and develop your own style, but the basic things like trying to hold a song of 95 BPM with one of 97, pitching them up and matching each other, have them lock for 10 seconds and training your ear to detect which one is drifting from the other, because we all could do that.
Yeah.
Back in the day when
Without visuals. I personally think technology is the greatest thing that ever happened.
It mashed up my back. It's a good thing.
Scratch Live in perspective. For me, since two turntables and a mixer, it has been the greatest thing.
Yeah, man.
But it has also resulted in a major downside in the business.
Major.
It has allowed some claffy.
Everyone's
some
claff, a DJ.
Everybody's
some
a DJ.
Some doofus.
Yeah, man.
Some doofus.
Some
like a pissing tear boy. Yeah. He decided to walk in 2 hours after me, a veteran in that business. One of the skillest DJ in this country. And you come in 2 hours after me with your pouch on top of your face.
No, Colin. Colin, that's not bad. I play a part and a man walk in. See me here?
Ready.
Yeah, man. Ready.
Memory, nothing.
Jump me up alone. Yeah, I'm saying.
Downgrade DJs, it limits.
Yeah, in terms of what you can charge.
No, but not all producers look at it that way, because sometimes it has to do with permission. It has to do with permission. Like a producer may want to do it, but the artist may say, boy, you don't want him. I can put it up here. And it's his right. So there's so much other things. It's not just about the producer, really.
That kind of counterproductive still, because if you have a song out there, you want your song to be played in every instance.
Yeah.
If I play an alternative set, I can't just throw in a dancer like that. I have to remix it, put it in an alternative set so it can fit your song and get played, everything and get played in any whatever set. You know, make no sense of all them politics, the way how the music can go right now. Better you just say, yo. Low people to be creative if you go whole hard in front until you kill the music, because some of the time, you know, honestly, you have some really dumb rhythms coming out, you know.
The song is good,
but you can't do nothing with it based on the rhythm.
Alright, what about that now, people? You have some software selector. Yeah, talk about them.
Software selector.
Some man come and dance, them call you and say, yo, you play, and you say, yeah, man. What time you reach? About 11:10:30. All right, cool.
Then reach 12.
Then mats. 12. That way, you already have this. All right. What talk about now? I'm going to do it.
DJ, please. How can you listen? Someone ears so grimy and
I don't use
people. How can you use somebody's headphones?
Headphone fungus.
One night, Len, my version of headphones.
Don't go and play on the flash it out. One point I can make to all of you in the contest, just have fun too. Yeah, that's important.
Fun is the main
part. All of the seriousness, yeah, but have fun.
Imagine this a countryman and all the fun we at a country and there.
Yeah, man.
Bring the food.
Have fun.
Man, I feel nice. Have so you talk about.
You know what's right now?
Pick up Heineken again, you know, the best thing ever happened to me.
Listen.
Clara, one of them, wait, I'm going to find my phone. Clara, give me all of our new phone.
Ray.
I wicked this phone ever.
You know, we're doing Heineken Green Synergy with Fiction, and you're our main house DJ at Fiction, so I wanted to know what your experience was like. I heard things didn't go kind of according to plan for you.
It was a fun experience.
We're in a competition and I'm here to win.
I learned a lot on the business side of things. I got to compete against some of the top DJs across the island.
Were you surprised it got you?
Yeah, I was.
Five of you are being scratched tonight. Five of you are going to be eliminated from the competition. This is our six pack. You five have been scratched from Heineken Green Synergy 2010.
I was surprised as well, but you know, we're working really closely with Heineken and the Green Synergy thing, and you know what's going on here tonight. You know, you're here, Ricky's here you're every night and so on, and do a great job for Fiction, and we really appreciate that.
Yeah.
But you know, tonight what's happening, you know, that we have the, obviously you see the promos and the setup and so on. You know, Heineken is in the house, and we have some great DJs, Delano, we have Richie D, we have Eric and Boyd, Sanjay, etc. So what I want you to do is I want to give you a chance to kind of show, kind of heard through the grapevine that Grandmaster Flash is actually going to be here tonight.
Yeah, for real?
Yeah, so, you know, we're really excited about it, as you as a DJ must be elated, but what, furthermore, he saw some of your footage, apparently, and so I guess I'm the bearer of kind of sort of news that he liked what he saw. So, So what I'm trying to do as Fiction and a team, and you've always been a team player, is that we want to give you kind of a chance to showcase yourself again. So we're kind of screechy and something. So I want you to take, you know, hold over. No, I'm serious. Hold over the. You're holding down the turntables for Fiction tonight. So in between whatever's going on with the other DJs, it's you. So he's already seen your tapes, etc. So I don't know what can happen of it, but anything can happen. So Bredgen, you have to do us proud.
Definitely.
You know what I'm saying? So do us proud and kill it.
Wow.
Gary was actually just telling a story that when we're up in the office, you know, in the daytime when Fiction is normally not open to the public, we hear music come on and go downstairs and see what's happening, and it's Ricky practicing for Green Synergy.
What's most impressive about Ricky is his dedication and his passion for what he's doing. It's amazing.
You're gonna have to play a 10-minute set to mimic the 15-minute set of the DJ you have chosen.
Keep it locked to Heineken Green Synergy 2K10.